Hi everyone! Today we want to do the Allied Beastrap quest from Stormblood. Before you can start this quest, you need to have finished all Beastrap quests of Stormblood. So, check this out. Reputation, Stormblood, Namatsu, Ananta and Kochin has to be rank 8 Bloodsworn. Otherwise you can't see this quest. Make sure you have finished them. So, okay. We talk to the East Aldenor Trading Company assistant here in Kugane at X13.1 Y9.8. The Ananta's Maid's Tale. Hancock's apprentice is peering about in earnest. Ah, Mrs. Wrench, Hancock sent me to look for you. I'm glad to have found you so close by. He said he needs to meet with you but wasn't clear on the details. I suppose he'd rather explain it to you in person. Would you mind taking a moment to speak with him? He's over at the harbor. Thank you. Just make your way to Pier 2. If you please, I'll let Hancock know he can find you there. Okay. Sweet, my friend. Good to see you again. Thank you for coming to meet me, though I confess that I knew you would. You are such an incredible sort, always ready to help your friends and close acquaintances. There's no need for such facial exertion. My request is a straightforward one. As it happens, I've been asked to escort a few members of the Alamegan Resistance on a tour of Kugane. It seems they are interested in seeing the fortifications that have allowed Hingashi to survive as an isolationist nation for so long. I've never met them, and it occurred to me that the presence of someone such as yourself, who has an established rapport with the Resistance, might smoothen our introduction. What say you? Right, you are my bosom companion. If I just have to stand there, fine. Right, you are my bosom companion. Good to hear, particularly as they'll be here any moment. By my estimation, they should be disembarking just about now. Aha, and right I am. Esteemed members of the Resistance, welcome to Kugane. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Hancock of the East Aldenor Trading Company, and I will be your guide to this fair city. I appreciate your coming to meet us. I'm Alpa, captain of the Velodina Gatekeepers. And I'm Joelmin, Alpa's second in command. Pleasure to meet you. Is that you, sweet? Fancy meeting you here. Of all places. What a pleasant surprise. Are you here to show us around? Now, that is an excellent proposal, Miss Alpa. I'm certain the two of you would feel more at ease seeing the city with someone you know. Don't you agree, sweet? In that case, I shall leave the role of guide to you. Meanwhile, I can secure accommodations for our guests. I get the feeling that you didn't have much choice there. Sorry about all this. If it's all right, I'd like to visit the castle first. I'm eager to see its fortifications. It's beautiful. It does look nice, but I can't imagine it's much use as a fortress. Too decorative. What unusual attire. I can see you are not a native to Kugane. May I ask where you hail from? By the Kami, the tale is real. Are you a mermaid? Don't be absurd. I am no mermaid. I am an Ananta. There are many like Alpa in Alamigo, our homeland. There's no need to be alarmed. Ah, so you are of a Western race then? Pardon me, I jumped to conclusions. It can be somewhat dull guarding the gate here, particularly as only an utter fool would try to break in, so I sometimes let my imagination get the best of me. It's all right, no offense taken. But if you have a moment, would you mind telling us more about this castle? I am curious as to how a single guard at the gate is sufficient to keep it secure. Of course, I'm no expert, but I will gladly teach you what I know. Consider it an apology for my rudeness. The central keep that towers above us is of a complex and strategic make, incorporating myriad defensive elements. As you can see, the most prominent part of the facade features regular openings from which to unleash a veritable hail of arrows or musket rounds. We call these Sama, and they make it nigh on impossible for an enemy to approach from the front. Oh no, it's raining. Similarly, those unlucky souls who attempt to scale the walls are like to be met by tumbling boulders or boiling oil released by those manning the many Pretices. Should one somehow manage to infiltrate the castle proper, he will find it a trial to get out again, for the pathways inside are maze-like by design. To think something could be so elegant in both form and function, I am impressed. All that said, the castle has been taken before. Not too long ago, an unscrupulous sword named Kageyama and his underlings managed to sneak in during one of the Bugyo's galas, taking advantage of the stream of people entering the castle. Which mainly goes to show that all of the clever defenses in the world mean nothing if you fail to check who's coming through the front door. A most instructive tale. Thank you. I had a feeling that I would find you here. Your accommodations are ready. Since your journey was a long one, I recommend that you stop for a soak in Kugane's famed hot springs before you continue your sightseeing. I can personally vouch for their efficiency in soothing body and soul. In that case, how could we refuse? That's settled, then just make your way to the Bokairo Inn and your leisure. I must return to the Ruby Bazaar, but I've ensured that you will find everything in order. My first Hingan Hot Springs. I hope you'll join us, sweet. She really is like a fairy tale mermaid come to life. The other brothers are in for a surprise. Okay. Where did I have to? Can I go there? This inn is spectacular. I've never seen anything like it. And to think that we can just go right in. I wish I could show it to Gales, though it might be safer not to. Anyway, Jomlin went inside to change ages ago, but it doesn't seem like she's coming out anytime soon. She does wear an awful lot of armor. Why don't we have a look around while we wait for her? There's no harm in that, right? Seeing it has only made me want to get in more. Jomlin won't mind if we meet her in the water, right? Right. So let's go. Unless you need some time to change into your bathing suit as well. I hear it's customary to wear one. At least in Kugane. Enter the hot springs in your current garb. Yes. This feels wonderful. I'm so glad we came to Hingashi. It's nice to properly relax once in a while. Look there. Is that a mermaid? The tail, those scales, unmistakably a mermaid. I can't believe they've been real this whole time. And right here in our hot springs. This is ridiculous. I'm clearly no fish. Ha! Suppose people who've never seen an Ananta just don't know what else to make of you. He again. Well, I never mermaid in the bath. Did someone say mermaid? What's this, a seeker? And one with most unfortunate features at that. Not as unfortunate as your manners. And I would say something about the creepy mask, but I reckon the face beneath is even worse. Now, am I meant to believe that you don't recognize me, Nazar Chab? You certainly have the look of an Eorzean, but perhaps my legacy has not yet reached whatever trapped little corner of the realm you call home. Yes, on closer inspection I can see that our Far Eastern friends simply mistook serpent for fish. Not that it matters for my purposes. Of course, I can hardly believe that I came up on a convincing substitute so soon. That's enough for your leering. What are you doing? Get your hands off me. Alpa? I swear you, masked maniac, if you've done something to Alpa. It's funny, I thought only to make a bit of coin on my travels through this foreign land, but it seems the Beastman and I are simply meant to be. In any case, I'll be helping myself to this one. I welcome a challenge, so feel free to hunt me down, if you can, ha! Oh, it's raining the whole time. Ah, okay. What was that? Hell's take that NASA. Ah, and what is he anyway? I can't believe he managed to snatch Alba right out from under us. No. Now's not the time. Our first priority needs to be tracking them down. Thankfully, if the locals' reactions so far are anything to go by, I'm sure they stood out. We can start by asking around. Okay. Ah, Mikote, ma'am, I'm afraid I don't quite know what you mean. Oh, right, I am talking about someone with ears like mine, male, a bit odd in the facial area. He might have been behaving strangely too. Does that ring a bell? Ah, so you folks are called Mikote. I've seen quite a few of you around Kugano of late. And there was a man fitting that description over by the short pier when I passed by not too long ago. I guess we are headed seaside then. Thanks for your help. This is not what I was expecting in a variety of ways. Now, what we have found him, I suppose we ought to make sure that he doesn't die. We're going to need him to wake up first, so I don't know, maybe poke him in the face. Ah, yeah. Okay. Poke. Close for blah, blah, blah. Poke him in the face. Let's try this. No, I would. Ah, no emotes needed. And you are sure he's not already dead? In that case, we'll have to get creative, and I have just the thing. Well, he does anyhow. Just as I thought, he never leaves home without his Mark XL2 grenades. I assume he took the time to remove some of the powder after his prior experiences, so they should be safe enough. Lob one in his general direction, would you? I'll stand back a bit just in case. I believe I at last truly grasped the meaning of the phrase a rude awakening, which is so to say, ow. Make no mistake, I am delighted to see you, sweet, but I would appreciate if you would put a little more thought into your method of greeting next time. I was having such a nice dream too. I can't say I expected quite that large of an explosion. I thought for sure you'd remember to take the powder out of this time. Powder out this time. But why are you here anyway? Garjamin? Jolmin. Your attire is rather less present than usual. Ah, now that you mention it, I did forget to put my uniform back on, didn't I? More importantly, so we have a serious problem on our hands. Nzet, are you listening to me? Yes, I'm listening, and definitely making a normal amount of eye contact. But never mind that. Alpa's been kidnapped. I saw her being carried away by a man with the most peculiar mask. You saw him? Yes. Yes. As it happens, I stowed away on your ship to get here, and that went perfectly smoothly, thank you very much, until you two disembarked and ran off, leaving me without a clue where to go. As I was wandering about aimlessly, as one does, I saw the masked man with Alpa in tow. I called out to them, and he hit me, without so much as a warning. Before I fully lost consciousness, however, I witnessed something vital, he and Alpa boarding a small boat. I am positive they were headed out to sea. Then there's not a moment to waste. We'll board the ship at once. You too, N'Zed. Of course, I would never abandon Alba in her time of need. In fact, I shall begin scanning the seas in search of any passing vessel that can carry us away right this moment. Feel free to say put on a coat while I do. Okay. Oh, we have loading problems here. Okay, that was the first Light Beast Trap quest from Stormblood. Thank you for watching. Bye bye, I'll see you in the next episode.